Now that we've discussed electricity and how to discuss quantitatively electricity as well as some of the variables there, we're ready to talk about circuits. To contextualize this, remember that we've already discussed all of our mechanics, and we'll be discussing magnetism after we cover how electricity flows through the circuits we're going to get into. We'll start this by first introducing the two main ingredients of a circuit that we'll need to remember and know how to deal with. Those are resistors, so we'll talk about Ohm's law and resistors now. And then we'll talk about the other ingredient, which is a capacitor, and then finally go into more complicated circuits and see how to work with resistors and even capacitors in bigger circuits as well. So let's start with Ohm's law and what a resistor is. In order to introduce this topic, we first need to have an idea about how we discuss the different variables that can be at play in a circuit. And then we'll discuss Ohm's law, which gives us a relationship between the variables that we introduce. And then finally, we will talk about resistors themselves and how to deal with them in a circuit and how to add them together. So first, let's introduce three variables, the voltage, current, and then the resistance. The current in a circuit, which will be one of the most important quantities that we're trying to find or measure, is telling you how much charge per second is flowing past a given point. So for example, in this wire that we have here, we have a wire with current flowing through it. That's all these electrons that we've shown moving here. And then they're all flowing past this dotted line, this particular point in our circuit. And current is measuring how many electrons are passing this point in a given amount of time, in a given second. We measure, therefore, the current exactly as you would expect. It's the number of coulombs, the amount of charge, passing a given point per second. And we call this coulombs per second an amp. So amps, which is symbolized by the letter A, is telling us how much current is flowing in a circuit, or how many coulombs per second. Interestingly, something important to know is that by a historical convention, again, something of a historical accident, we actually measure current in the positive direction. So even though electrons themselves, the actual electricity of the electrons flowing through the circuit, is the flow of negative charges, which is what the electrons are, we define current to be the flow of positive charge, which isn't to say that actual protons, positive charges, are moving. It's just to say that the flow of positive charge is defined in the opposite direction as the flow of the negative charge. And usually this won't be a problem, not something you have to actually worry about. But if you do see electrons drawn on a circuit flowing, always keep in mind that the current, by definition, is defined in the opposite direction of that electron flow. The second quantity that we should be familiar with is the voltage. We've already discussed the voltage in the sense of just electricity and electric fields and the electric potential, but we're going to talk about voltage in circuits as the energy per coulomb again, except this time we'll probably more think about the voltage as a pressure in terms of trying to push the electrons through the circuit. We'll talk about batteries as well and how these batteries are acting as pumps, sort of pushing the electricity through your circuit. So if you see this battery on the bottom here, the way we talk about this battery is that the positive side of the battery is the side with the longer line. So we represent a battery in these sort of series of lines, which is in fact representative of the cells, the battery cells that are in this cell or battery. And we always, by convention, discuss the positive side of the voltage, where we're pushing the current in the positive direction, as the part of this battery with small line, big line, that ends in the bigger line. And so again, this battery is sort of a pump for our circuit. It's trying to push the electricity to flow through the circuit. Now, when we have a particular voltage flowing and pushing, rather, a current through a particular circuit, we can ask ourselves the exact same kind of question that we asked with fluid flow. When we had fluid flow, we talked about the pressure, how much pressure we were applying to a system, and then asked for a given amount of pressure, how much current, how much flow rate, as we called it there, was going to flow through our circuit. And we saw that that depended on the resistance of the circuit. And so in that context, we called it the circuit law for the flowing systems. In this case, we are actually introducing the circuit law by writing down the resistance as the ratio of the voltage, the amount of pressure we apply, per amount of current that we get out. The resistance, this quantity that we've just introduced, has units of volts per amp, since it is the voltage divided by the current. So we call 1 volt per amp an ohm, and it's represented by a capital Greek letter omega, as you see here.